I was born and bred in Wakefield in the early 80s. The city centre was on its real heyday, real high. You know, I could never get in any of the bars. I always used to put a shirt and tie on, and they used to know which doorman used to say, "Oh no, you're not coming in, lads, you're not coming in." You know, we're like 17, and I thought if I put a shirt and tie on, they're going to let me in. Westgate was a destination venue. Wakefield was a destination venue. When the disco era changed, Wakefield changed as well. The upgrading of the buildings over the last couple of years has re-sparked everything off again. The nighttime economy is booming in Wakefield.
I'm obsessed and I've always been fascinated by old buildings. I think when I was seven, I drew the west front of Wren Cathedral with a felt tip pen, and my mum and dad just kind of, they thought it was so fantastic, they framed it and put it in the at the top of the stairs. I knew then. I think it's one of those things, it's just in you, isn't it? I don't know, I just love it. I get a little buzz out of it. I was involved originally with the Wakefield Heritage Action Zone as an overseeing kind of architect. I was asked to do a survey of 23 buildings on Westgate and assess their condition and assess the potential list of repairs. Without Historic England funding, you know, we would be losing the historic and listed buildings in these towns. I mean, it's as simple as that. The rich tapestry of the sort of history of a town is incredibly important to its local residents.
The revival of the buildings on Westgate has given Westgate and Wakefield a uniqueness. We understand that the building was completely covered in granite by Lloyds Bank, covering up the original Lloyds Bank fascia. I suppose it was all part of regeneration in the 1970s to modernise buildings. As all the granite came off, they revealed the most beautiful original sandstone frontage. We cannot believe that this is the end result of it, and we're really, really delighted with it.
When I bought the bar, I saw that there were the original cast iron arms there, and then it was all boarded up. And when we looked, there was the original awning still there. And part of the funding from Historic England has been to help get those renovated. So yeah, it is good that they're back, you know, and the arms are the original ones. It's just the fabric that had to be replaced. It's lovely to see that these Victorian parts of the building have been thoroughly restored.
My favourite building in the HAS scheme is the building at 628 Silver Street. I had to get that building. I desperately wanted to see what was going on. Originally, the building was covered with expanded metal mesh and cement render, but I knew that there was something really quite special hidden underneath. What was uncovered was a three-storey jettied timber frame building, probably dating from 1590.
So I don't know how you're going to navigate the ladder, but
Nigel is a lime specialist. What he doesn't know about plaster isn't worth knowing about.
On a simple analysis, we realised that the original mortars were lime and hair only, a lot of hair, but pure lime and hair, and that's what we're reproducing here. So we're working like for like, and that to me is a very important principle. And I take huge personal satisfaction from preserving the work that these guys did, and women too, in many cases. You get huge pleasure out of saying, oh, well, this is how they solved a little problem. Some people might call it a bodge, but as long as you bodge with the right materials, that can have its charm, believe me. Working on buildings like this is why I'm in this industry. It's what floats my boat. These buildings are part of the cultural identity of the town and of individuals, and for me, that makes that nebulous concept real. This is the reality of what that concept is, and people identifying with that and being proud that it's in their town.
So yeah, as you can see, scaffold down, everything revealed, it looks incredibly beautiful. The subtlety of the colour just seems to draw out the browns in the wood and prevent it looking kind of Victorian black and white. So it's really nice to get back to a kind of historic colour scheme. I feel really proud that I've managed to work on it, but also I'm just really pleased what it's giving back to the people of Wakefield. There's absolutely no reason for it not to kind of continue in a good state of repair for, 100, 200 years. That's the aim of the scheme, that's the aim of my job, that's what I do, that's what I love, that's, yeah, purpose of my life.